My name is Anne-Marie McDonald, and I'm the principal at Bay Ridge Secondary School. I am coming to you from my home office. And I'd like to just outline what our plan is for this evening. I'll also note that we are intending to record this evening's session. So post that for anyone who wasn't able to join us tonight. We can give you an overview of our Bay Ridge Computer Science program. I'm going to do some introductions here shortly, and then I'll set the stage for tonight. I will also note that we have two people who will be helping to facilitate this evening's session. First off, our Bay Ridge Computer Science teacher, Mr. John Swain, who will be joining you shortly, and then our student success teacher, Mr. Steve Gambacourt, who will be a bit of a gremlin behind the curtain. He will be moderating the chat this evening and providing us with tech support. Our intention is to open things up throughout the session for questions. So as anything pops into mind, feel free to post it in the chat. And then we'll have a question and answer period at the end. And we hope to keep you for then. So I realize that you might be here for different reasons. Some of our senior students or their parents might be here because they are interested in knowing more about how we will help prepare their students for post-secondary pathways into STEM and computer science avenues. We might have junior students or their parents here because they haven't had a chance really to learn about our program and what we have to offer. To see another person to admit there. And then might possibly some incoming grade nines or incoming grade nine families who are at stage looking at what opportunities might be presented in high school. So again, hopefully you'll walk away with a full overview of what we have to offer at Bay Ridge, and we will answer all of your questions along the way. You are likely aware that jobs in STEM and coding last while. And you may also be aware that the ministry has embedded coding in the new grade 9 de-streamed math program. And I think both of those things are indicative of the opportunity that STEM and computer science offer to students for their future. And I will unabashedly share that I believe we have the best educator in the system in our computer science programming, and that's Mr. John Swain. And I can say that, I think, even as an outside observer. I've been principal at Bay Ridge just since September, but I've certainly known of Mr. Swain's work long before that, and he's highly regarded, highly respected in the system. And I also really, truly mean this when I say that I believe that Bay Ridge has the most rigorous and robust offering in the system for students who are interested in this. So without further ado, I would like to now turn it over to Mr. Swain. And again, feel free to populate our chat with questions as we go and a Q&A at the end. Mr. Swain, thank you.
All right, thank you very much, Ms. McDonald. Hi, everybody. I'm coming to you live from Bay Ridge. I decided to come into my room to kind of show it off. So at the end, if I remember, I'm going to try to pick up my laptop and twirl it around and you can see what's going on. I'm not going to do it right away because I said to my wife before I left, like, it when we have these virtual meetings, everyone's gotten used to them, but the computer guy is not allowed to have tech problems because it looks really bad when that happens. It's not fair, but that's the way it is. So I'm too afraid that if I pick up my laptop, my dual monitor system is going to break down. And anyway, we'll do that at the end. So thank you very much for taking the time to come and kind of find out what this is all about. I would like this to be pretty informal. So if at any point you have a question and then you think, you know, it would be best answered in the moment, no problem. Please throw it in the chat and I will address it either in the moment or I'll get to it at the end. But this is for you. This is not for me. I'm going to talk to you about what this program is, how it's evolved, the things that your student will get when they come and be part of the Bay Ridge Computer Specialist Program. But Again, the whole point is that you get your questions answered. So please don't be shy. And that goes for parents and students. I want to hear from everybody. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my screen with you all. So you should now be seeing a website that says BCSP at the top. And I think we're good. I've got Mr. Gambacourt with me here in the room, and he's telling me that we're good. So you should be seeing it. And if at any point there are any technical problems, please, again, use the chat or however to let us know something's up, and we'll try to fix it. Okay? So this is the first thing you're seeing. Well, firstly, I maintain this website. I was going to make a Google slideshow for tonight. I actually started to make it. And then I thought, why would I do that? I have a website already, and I maintain this website to try to give people information about the Bay Ridge Computer Specialist Program. You can get to this website anytime. In fact, if you want, you can even go there now. I'd rather that you let me take you through it, but the easiest way for you to do that, and maybe I can get somebody to type this in the chat for me, is bit.ly/Mr. Swain. And that's a URL shortener. So if you hit that, it will then take you here, and then you can click and you can find out all about the Bay Ridge Computer Specialist Program. So what I've tried to do is I've tried to compile all of the information that I'm going to tell you here. And that way, you know, if there's something that you forget or something you want to, share with your friends or anything like that, it's always going to be here for you. And I'm only planning on adding to it in the future. So this is the homepage, and what you're seeing here is I tried to make an overall poster of what the BCSP was all about. So it is, and I am going to do some reading to you tonight. It is a specialized program beginning in the fall of 2021. And what it is it's to expose students to a variety of topics in computer science. Basically, I've been teaching since about 2008. I've taught math and I've taught computers. And when I came to Bay Ridge, the math was very well taken care of. We have one of the best math departments in the board, run by a very beautiful woman who is also my wife, so I'm a little biased, but we do. We have an amazing math department. We have more math leads than any school on the board. We have an amazing AP program that's run like no other. So I looked around, and I was like, okay, well, math is clearly covered. But I used to be a computer programmer before I was a teacher. I worked down at Queen's in neuroscience. I worked in the lab, and I decided I really wanted to try to drive the computer programming and the computer science at Bay Ridge. And very, very early on, it became evident to me that there was a niche for it here. The first time I had a meeting to try to get students involved in a computers club, I had 23 kids come to the meeting. And at the previous school I was at, the most I ever had was 7. And so I thought, this is great. And slowly over time, I decided that is my passion. I want to expose students to more than they're getting in their typical computer science classes. I do feel like there's a bit of a hole there in education. I don't feel like we do, as a system, I don't feel like we do enough kind of immersing kids in computer science, and that's what this is all about. So students who kind of get involved in the Bay Ridge Computer Specialist Program, they are immersed in the program throughout high school. So the idea is they come in grade 9, and there's no application process. There's no, you know, you've got to be good enough to get into it. There's nothing like that. They come in and they say, hey, I really like computer science. I'm interested in this program, and that's all I need. And they come in and we get them involved in computers club, and they meet kids who are like-minded and have similar interests, and we go from there. And what you're seeing here is kind of a flow chart. Think of it that way, where they start in grade 10 in the junior grades, and as they go to the senior grades, these over here on the left are the courses that they take. And I should mention that we are definitely one of the only schools around that has a grade 9 computer science course. And we're also one of the only ones has a grade 12 computer, or sorry, AP course, which I'll talk about a little later. And we even have another one now called a grade 12 computer engineering and leadership course. So most schools have grade 10 and maybe 11 and 12, if you're lucky. And we have more, we have five instead of three, which is wonderful. Then outside of the classroom, we have all kinds of different kind of topics that we, again, immerse is the word I come back to. We get them involved in as they're at Bay Ridge. And then they have all kinds of reach ahead activities and opportunities as well while they're here. So I consider this to be my back of the book summary type thing. And the idea is tonight I want to take you a little further than that and kind of identify what exactly do you do while you're here. So again, I'm going to take you through the website, and please don't be shy to type anything you like in the chat at any point. Excuse me. So the idea is that students come in grade 9, and again, they identify right away that, okay, I want to be involved in this program. I really like computers. So what do I do? And this is what happens in grade 9. So in grade 9, students come in and, of course, they enroll in the TEJ10 course, which is an intro to computer technology. And basically in that course, we do, what I find is a lot of elementary schools are doing block coding now, where they use programs like Scratch and maybe, if you're lucky, a little bit of Minecraft Educational Edition. And so I take those programs, Minecraft Education and Scratch, and I basically go, I go quite a bit further with them. So I introduce a lot of the core concepts of computer science, while at the same time not quite getting into the technical aspects that can frustrate students when they start learning about computer programming. And so the students are, I want them to be creative. If you've ever used Minecraft before or watched your children use Minecraft, it is quite incredible what they can build and where their brains go. I say over and over, the kids know way more about Minecraft than I do. And so they teach me about Minecraft while I teach them about coding and kind of open their eyes to what's possible when they use the code builder in Minecraft and in Scratch. So that's what they do in the classroom in the TEJ10 course as part of the BSCP. Outside of class, so again, this is in the classroom, and I should be clear, like there are lots of kids who take the TEJ10 who are not part of the BCSP. However, students who are part of this program, they're expected to do a little bit more. So they're automatically part of the Bay Ridge Computer Club. And yes, I saw that in the chat. We do have over 40 students. It's a bit of a zoo in here at lunch, but it's pretty great because we often have students who, they might have some trouble making friends, especially in grade 9, and they come in this room and they kind of light up. They're around the people who they can do programming with, and they have lots of great ideas, and it's really quite a scene. It's great to see. And at the same time, in grade 9, they get involved in an online coding course. So I'm going to click on the first of many links tonight. So if I click here, you see this is a website, the University of Waterloo. It's called Computer Science Circles. And basically, this is an online Python course. And so students who are involved in the Bay Ridge Computer Specialist are expected to get started on an online Python course that they do, and also an online Java course. So they start to learn a little bit about the fundamentals of programming. In addition, they have opportunities to get involved in clubs like Minecraft Club or Cybersecurity Club. And again, I'm going to talk about that a little bit more later. They also participate in a computing challenge called the Beaver Computing Challenge, which we actually just wrapped up. We had 130 students at Bay Ridge who did that. And we got out into the community and we did some stuff at elementary schools, and we had over 600 kids at elementary schools do that as well. And they have the option to write another computing contest called the Canadian Computing Competition, again, from the University of Waterloo. All the while, they have to track their hours. So as part of what they're doing in the BCSP, they're involved in things outside of the classroom, and they should be tracking their hours. And the reason is because when they get to kind of the end game in grade 12, They are able to kind of go, hey, here's everything that I did. Here's all the hours I put towards this. And that helps us determine the level of certification they get. And again, I will get into that. So here's some pictures of our grade nines here. Okay, and then they get to grade 10. And in grade 10, again, there's another course they take, of course. And this one is computer hardware, software, and networking. I'm actually teaching this one right now. So we do things like we rip apart computers. We actually kind of dissect them and learn what all the parts are, what they do, how they work. We also learn about the internet, how the internet works. It's getting more and more depressing for me to teach this unit because the students have no clue what the world was like before the internet. And I have to start a lot of my sentences with the words back in my day or when I was a lad, and they laugh at me. It's great. And then we get into programming for the first time. So in grade 10, we start to talk about the Java programming language, and we do a little bit of game programming. So that's where we're at right now in this course that I'm teaching. And currently the students are making Space Invaders, and they're having a blast doing that. They continue to be part of Computer Club. They do the Beaver Computing Challenge again. In grade 10, they have to do the Canadian Computing Competition. In grade 9, it's optional, but in grade 10, they have to. And then there's another group programming competition. And this one, I don't know what's going to happen this year, especially now with 216 cases today. But in the past, what we've done is we go down to Queens, and we actually work in groups on problems down there, and it's really, really fun. So I'm hoping that we'll at some point be able to do that one again. That's a really fun fun thing to do. Now in grade 10, at the end of the year, they start looking, excuse me, I got my water here. In grade 10, at the end of the year, they start looking for, I'm calling it a co-op. And so the idea is, students find something that they can do to help a business or organization or our own school, or they work at a job or something like that, something outside of school. And that's why we're calling it a co-op, and they have to put in 100 hours. And so a couple of examples, we have a student right now working with a local business, creating a customer database. We have a student working with our own student success department on a website designed to attract grade 8 students. We had two students last summer work in the Center for Advanced Computing at Queen's University. And this year I have a couple of contacts already in Ingenuity Labs down at Queen's, where they're doing artificial intelligence. So there's lots of different ideas that we have and kind of leads that we have. But basically we're looking for students to go out and try to find something that they like, whether it's making websites or, you know, anything to help a local business and kind of do a job in that realm. The other ones that come to mind are, we've had lots of charities that need help. There's lots of small organizations around Kingston that need websites made or little customer databases made, and the students get involved with that, and it's often quite rewarding. And so that starts at the end of grade 10. And then they work away at that co-op all the way up to the end of grade 12, and they have to compile up to 100 hours. We can get pretty creative with that co-op. If a student's really having a hard time finding something, we'll find something. We've got enough ideas that we will find something there. Then we're off to grade 11. And in grade 11, there's the first real programming-specific course. So grade 11 university, that is the first course that's devoted solely to programming. And in there we do website creation. So they learn a little bit about HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, which are the foundations of web design. And also they continue to learn Java, more Greenfoot, more of the program that we did in grade 11. And in grade 11, students have the first opportunity to do an AP exam. So in the world of computers, AP is a little bit different. There's two different AP options. There's the AP Principles, and then there's the AP CSA. This one that I'm talking about in grade 11 is AP Principles. And for this one, they actually have to develop a portfolio, and it has to do with, it's not just about programming, it's also about computers and society and stuff like that. And then there is an exam. And this one is not, we there is no, again, it's different because, for example, in the world of math, you take the AP math course and then you can write the AP exam if you want to. In this, anyone who is interested in doing the AP computer science principal exam would come to see me and the good people in student services. We would work with them and try to, you know, make sure they know what they have to do, but they would do some independent work on top of what they're doing in the grade 11 computers course. So it's a little bit different, but we can certainly work with students towards challenging this exam. If for those of you not familiar, by the way, why would you do an AP exam? One of the most common reasons is because if you do well on an AP exam, it often leads to equivalencies in university. So if you were to do very well on this exam and the other computer science exam, you could wind up with 2 university credits before you even go. And that does depend on which university you choose, but that's why. In addition, in grade 11, you're also still doing the computing competitions, the one University of Waterloo, the one at Queen's. And then there is an online cybersecurity course. And right now this one is optional for grade 11s, but again, another very good thing to do. Cybersecurity is extremely valuable this day and age. And so another opportunity where they can get involved in cybersecurity. And right now we do have a cybersecurity team at Bay Ridge with, I believe, 14 students right now. So that's great. And that is also grade 11, where they start getting involved in outreach activities, where they go out to elementary schools and work with young kids and do coding sessions and lots of great stuff like that. Grade 12. So grade 12 is when they take the ICS4U. That's the grade 12 university level course. And they have the option to take the TEJ4M, which is our computer leadership. So starting quickly, the ICS4U is essentially all programming. And it will prepare them to do what's called the AP Computer Science A exam. Students don't have to write the exam. Again, the exam, it costs money to write it, and not all students are going to need that. But the ICS4U will certainly prepare them for that exam that is to be written in May. And then the TEJ4M course is a computer leadership course, which is new and going very well. Basically, the idea is that students will come to me and they will identify some aspect of computer science that they're very passionate about. And then we kind of design sort of a course of their own. And we arrive at the ideas of what they're going to do, how they're going to do it, what they're going to learn. And for example, we just ran this in Quad 1. And a student made a database-driven website, which was pretty unbelievable. Worked very independently on that project, and I can show that to you a little bit later. and then, excuse me, I'm just going to take a drink of water. Outside of class, our grade 12 students who are involved in the program are our leaders, so they are the ones who really kind of help the junior students at Computer Club, and they also are the leaders on our cybersecurity team. So over the course of grade 9 to grade 12, the students are gaining mentorship skills and becoming the leaders of the club. We have a couple things we run at Bay Ridge. Last year, we ran what's called the Bay Ridge Elementary Computer Challenge. Some of you who are here may have been involved in that. I'm not sure. But basically, it was a night where we had elementary school teams come into a virtual environment, and they did a little computer challenge. And so the idea is the grade 12s who are involved in the BCSP helped to run that night. They also helped to run the computer or the Beaver Computing Challenge. And they continue to participate in their own contests like the Canadian Computing Competition and the Echo down at Queen's. So it's a lot of talking, but that is kind of a run through of exactly what students will go through as they go from grade 9 to grade 12. Now, what is the end game? So what happens upon graduation? Well, when they graduate, students will graduate with a certificate that is going to be endorsed by Bay Ridge Secondary School and the School of Computing at Queen's. So about a month ago, I had a great meeting with the Dean of Computing at Queen's University. I told him all about what we were doing in our program. He actually had kids that went to Bay Ridge, so he was happy to talk to Bay Ridge, and he was very he wished that his kids had gone here when we had this program available, and he was quite excited about it. And we basically agreed on an informal partnership between Queen's and Bay Ridge, and we are going to be developing kind of more formalized activities and workshops and mentorships with their students. And that's something I'm really, really excited about. And at that moment, he gave me the go ahead that Queen's will be kind of sponsoring this program, which is super cool. So their certification will say that they have completed all of the mandatory components of the BCSP. However, since there are going to be a different levels of activities, some students will put in X amount of hours in whatever activities they're doing. Other students might do more. So there might be some students who get involved in lots and lots of different things, and some students who just kind of do the bare minimum. So we are going to have three levels of certification. There's bronze, which would be the minimum level, silver, which would be your in between, and gold, which would be the maximum level of certification. And this distinction, so when students are in grade 12, there will be a consultation with me just kind of talking about the certification level that they've achieved and that kind of thing. Also, students, so I don't know how to say this without this line here that I wrote. I didn't know how to say that without sounding maybe a little bit pompous, I don't know. But I've never, ever had a student come back saying that they were not fully prepared for the next step in computer science. So what else will they get? Well, the students will be extremely well prepared for post-secondary in terms of computers. They will know a minimum of three different programming languages, and they will have all kinds of other related experiences, depending on what it is they choose to do while they're here. So they will be absolutely prepared for the next step. They also will have quite a portfolio. Again, the folks in student services have offered to help the students track what they do. So they have a digital tracking sheet while they're here. And they also have I'm a computer guy. What's the opposite of digital? They have a paper copy. So in student services, everyone has a folder. And every time they complete something that gives them a certificate or any kind of tracking, they can print that off, bring it to student services, and we can track all of their stuff. And then when they're done, our student services team can help them make resumes and do cover letters reflecting all the things that they've done in the BCSP. And lastly, just because of all the connections that they're going to make while they're part of the program, whether it be at Queen's or St. Lawrence or in business with the city, you name it, we've got lots and lots of different kind of ways to network. And so a lot of times kids have inside track on summer jobs. For example, we have students, in fact, this girl here in the picture worked at Queen's in a computer coding outreach doing camps. And another student she was doing an outreach program for engineering. And we had another student who was doing a coding camp at Queen's for kids. So lots of links as well. Down lower, we have the point form details by grade. And this is pretty much what I just said, maybe with a little bit more detail. And really the only reason that this exists is because if there's one thing I know, it's that kids don't often read paragraphs. And so point form sometimes does the trick for them. So this is just a little bit more, I guess, less writing, but the same information so students can remind themselves once in a while what exactly they have to do at each level. Okay, so there we go. That is kind of your general overview of the entire course. Now, when it comes to all of the different things that we offer, all of the clubs and the reach ahead opportunities, again, there's a lot. And I'm noting the time, 7:30 already. I won't go into as much detail as I planned here, but I would love for you to take your time and go through this page, because this is just some of all of the things that we offer at Bay Ridge in terms of, outreach and extras. So These are the amazing guest speakers that we've had come into our classroom and talk to our students. We've had Dr. Wendy Pally from Queens. Colin Breck is a former graduate of Bay Ridge and also happens to be my best friend who lives out in California, and he works for Tesla. And he's come in and talked about his life out in California working in high tech. We've had the Queens Women in Computing Group come in. Dr. Marshall, he runs the artificial intelligence lab I was talking about down at Queens, and he actually had our students to a symposium. And this symposium was actually world renowned. I don't think my students fully understood what they were getting when they got to go to that symposium for free. And more. Professor Ruskin, I've got to make note of Professor Ruskin because I believe she's in the crowd. And Professor Ruskin at St. Lawrence has had us down a number of times to do some great workshops down there, and many other things here. So I'll let you read those a little later. Here's a picture of the Queens Women in Computing Group that came in. You can see how many Bay Ridge young women went and attended and learned about all the opportunities they had in computer science. In terms of clubs and teams, we offer quite a few. So here's all of our, this is Computers Club. So again, as part of the BCSP, when you join, you're automatically in the club. You don't have to pay your dues or anything. And as you can see, we take it seriously. I've got my swag on here, and everybody gets a t-shirt or a hoodie. We got to look good. So we have more than 40 plus students involved, always looking to add more. What kinds of things do we do? Well, in Computers Club, students often come in at lunch and they work away on their online courses and they help each other out. But we also have kind of branches where we have developed a BSS Minecraft Club. And the Minecraft Club, right now, their goal is to recreate Bay Ridge Secondary School in Minecraft. And we have 17 people working on that project. We elected a president last week, and they're slowly working away to their goal. And I'm very much looking forward to seeing what they have. We have a cybersecurity team, and this team actually, they learn all about hacking, but it's good hacking. It's not the evil hacking. And so students who get involved with cybersecurity, they all work together, and there's a website here called Pico CTF, and this is CTF stands for Capture the Flag. And so students who sign up for this play Capture the Flag games using computer science and hacking to understand cybersecurity, to understand what websites that aren't very secure look like and how they can be exposed and how they can be fixed. So that's kind of a cool club. And again, I think we've got about 14 students doing that. We have a live streaming club that just started. Actually, again, COVID is horrible and awful and we hate it, but it did kind of lead to this club because we needed a way to broadcast our athletics. And now we have a group of 5 students who have kind of almost become a broadcasting channel. And if you go to our Bay Ridge Blazers YouTube channel, you can see some of their handiwork. There's a basketball game here. There we go. And so slowly but surely, we are getting more and more stuff involved there. It's interesting with this one because students are actually taking a lot of the skills that they've learned in the gaming realm, using a program called OBS to stream their stuff, and they're using it to stream live events from our gym. And it's kind of exploded. Like, it only started a couple weeks ago. It's going really well. And we also have a Bay Ridge website and graphic design club. We do have our own. I bought a website called bsscompsci.ca. I'll click it, but you're not going to see anything fun yet because it's brand new. We just started, so I haven't even put anything up yet. But we do have room for any student who wants any web space to fool around with and create websites and stuff like that to do so. So we've got lots of opportunity there. The contests and challenges I've talked about already, so I'll skip over a little of that. But the Beaver competition is a competition meant for grade 5 all the way up to grade 10. And we set a record in 2019 with 81 students participating. And we broke that record by quite a bit this year with over 100. I can't remember the exact number. And also, we've had that out in the community. The Canadian Computing Competition is this one is an actual coding competition. So when the students do their online course in grade 9, they learn enough that they can participate in this competition. And then as they continue to learn more and more about coding and programming, they have, you know, they gain more and more skills to do better and better in this competition. And again, this one is through the University of Waterloo, and online they have all kinds of practice and you know, other information about the competition. So anybody can go and learn about it anytime. Here's a picture of students writing. I tried to get some pictures on the website, but you know, there's not a whole lot of action shots of programming competitions. There's no one running around the room or anything, so they're all just sitting there doing their stuff. This is the Queen's one that I referred to. And this is when we actually got to go down to Queen's and do the competition down there in teams. This team here did quite well. And here's another one from 2018. Excuse me, I'm losing my voice. Okay. Oh my God, I am losing my voice. No, I'm not even kidding. I'll make it through. Okay, so Adventures in High Tech is a very, very cool program sponsored by the Rotary Club of Nepean Kanata. And again, it was much cooler before COVID, but we were actually able to send 4 Bay Ridge students to Ottawa, where they got to visit companies like EA Sports and Google and the University of Ottawa and Algonquin. And they stayed with families in Ottawa that were part of Rotary for 4 days. I know for a fact that this program actually changed the life of one particular student who is now at Algonquin College doing programming. And we are lucky enough to have a link to a gentleman named Paul Elsley, who has come to Bay Ridge 3 years in a row, and we've been able to send students. We actually did it again in 2021 virtually, but still got the experience. Super cool. We do local field trips all the time. So having worked at Queen's before, I do have quite a few links down there. So we've been to Queen's for, this was a computer science open house. We've been to the neuroscience area where I used to work. This is down at the Innovation Hub. Andrea, you would recognize that, I hope, at St. Lawrence. And so we try to get out as much as we can. Obviously, maybe not as much in the last couple of years, but we do like to get out and see what's in the community. The University of Waterloo Sparks program was for a grade 10 student who was able to go to Waterloo and be part of a week-long workshop for young women interested in STEM. And we've sent kids 2 years. So we've had 2 Bay Ridge students go to this, and it's been super cool. And then we do take pride in our community outreach and mentoring. I'm okay. I'll make it through. Oops, sorry, didn't mean to click that. Oh yeah, this is an article about us in the WIG. So when we were out doing some work with coding and in the community, we go to Bay Ridge, Trudell, Lancaster, Catwood, Sinclair, and Calvin Park all the time. And I know that there are some people in the crowd who are from those schools, so shout out to you. And what you're seeing here are some pictures of students when they used to come into our room, again, before COVID was a thing. And here are the pictures of the many, many kids who went out to schools and worked with kids trying to expose elementary school children to computer science and everything it offers. So, and this is, again, something that we do in the Bay Ridge Computer Science program. We constantly want our, especially our senior students, to get out there and promote computer science and work with young kids. And then, of course, the co-op opportunities I talked about already, many of those being down at Queen's, so I gave them the logo here. And we're always looking for other co-op opportunities, whether it be for business, organization. And we also have many within our own school, too, whether it's creating an athletics website or helping to create the student services website or the grade 8 website or wherever it may be. So there you go. There's all of the things that I could think of that are currently available to students who are part of the BCSP, which is, I think, ample. Okay, now, other than that, so again, I know it's 7:41, I am cognizant of my time here, so I do want to quickly just show you kind of some shout outs that we've got recently. This is all from Twitter, but this is, again, just Bay Ridge going out to schools in the community, working with kids. So this was us getting students ready for the Beaver Computing Challenge. This one's at Lancaster. This one's at Bay Ridge. This one's at Trudell. This one's at Wellborn. Another one at Lancaster. This is Trudell again. Yeah, lots and lots of stuff in the community. This was last year when we had 3 Bay Ridge students win awards in Ontario for young women in computing. So yeah, lots of stuff going on Twitter. We have had a couple of videos made about the program and about coding in general, which I won't play right now. Here is our Computer Science Wall of Fame. And so this is my daughter, a little bit of a shout out there to my daughter who graduated last year, but we have a couple of graduation awards, which again, I don't think any other schools do in the realm of computer science. So we have 2 grad awards for students when they get done at Bay Ridge, both with monetary value. And one of them is the Queen's School of Computing Aspirations and Computing Award, and then the Queen's Women in Computing Excellence in Computing Award. And we've given that out 2 years. So this has been since 2019, we've had this. And then we have our own little wall of fame here that students don't have to win awards to be on. These are just students who have really done amazing things in our building for computer science and have graduated and gone on to computer science in post-secondary. And then, of course, we have some friends of the program. So just recently, this is Dr. Scott Compo. And he is someone who works at Queen's, and he constantly comes in, does workshops with our kids. So we got him a hoodie. And then we have Dr. Marshall, who runs the AI lab, and we got him a hoodie. And then this is Professor Wendy Powley, who is constantly coming in and do stuff especially with our young women, trying to promote young women in STEM. So she got a hoodie. And then there's Paul Elsley, who runs the Rotary Exchange. And he got a hoodie. You always got to give back to the community. There's a little more information here on computer science courses. So I talked a little bit about the TEJ course in grade 9, and I talked about the ICS in grade 10. I'm not going to take you through these, but if you do want some more information on exactly what happens in those courses, there it is for you. And then student work. So we do have a little bit of I'm going to take a little bit of time just to show off a little bit of student work. And so here we have some Greenfoot games. So I made this little presentation, and I think I am going to take the time to play it, give my voice a small little rest. So hopefully this will hold up okay over the network. And this does have some music, some Beastie Boys to it. So if your volume's up, just a bit of a heads up here. Not sure how loud this is going to come out. But what you're going to see here is just a showcase, I suppose, of games that were made by grade 11 students using a program called Greenfoot and a language called Java. So I'll just take a second to show this off. All right. There you go. You have Beastie Boys in your head for the rest of the night. And then we do have another version from 2021-22, which I'm not going to show right now, but feel free to go ahead and watch that one too. I showed that because what I like about that is, like, this is, it kind of shows that I don't love to mandate exactly what the students are going to do. They do what they're passionate about. They are creative. And one of the things I often say to my students is when they start asking me questions and they start with the word, Mr. Swain, can I? The answer is always yes. It's just a matter of how much work they want to put in to do it. But that's the beauty of computer science, is if you have an idea, that's really all you need. And you can then go from there and just get it done, and you can wind up making some pretty cool stuff like that. So we have Scratch games here. We have only a few that I've posted, but I've loaded some work there. So if there are any students out there listening, you're more than welcome to go and play some of these Scratch games and see the kind of stuff that we've done. This would be in grade 9. And then Greenfoot, these aren't playable right in the window, but if you were to click here, for example, it would take you to the Greenfoot site, and you can actually play. This is Michael Cox, who is an unbelievable programmer, and he made his own version of Zelda and called it The Legend of Michael. And so you can go and play The Legend of Michael, as many, many people have. You can see it's got its own comments because it's so good that people in the Greenfoot community took note of it. And then under Minecraft as well, you can go and take a look at some of the things that we've done in Minecraft. For example, this is a student who made a golf course in Minecraft. So he wrote code so that when you ran a certain command in Minecraft, it would make a golf course, and then you could actually play the golf course using a bow and arrow. So this is my drive here coming up. There we go. And then you go down the course and you pick it up and you go and try to hit the redstone. So again, creativity and you know, no boundaries on what they can do. So you can go and take a look at what other kinds of things we've done. And again, I'll be posting more as we do more. And then there's a few other things like coding resources that I don't think I need to show. And that brings me to pretty much what I wanted to tell you. That's pretty much the end of what I wanted to do. And so I thank you very much for listening to me for 45 minutes. I hope that was somewhat educational for you. And I would love to open up the floor to any questions. This is where I really would like to hear feedback, questions. What is it that you would like to know about what we offer here at Bay Ridge? Would first robotics competition hours work towards 100 hours? Yes, I don't see why not. Basically, anything that would qualify as kind of computer science realm pretty much would. So yeah, I believe it would. And that is also, by the way, that is the nice thing about what we're doing here, is that if a student already has a passion that kind of falls into this, I've had students come into grade 9 who have already done some, coding courses, and yeah, they absolutely do count towards what we're doing here. So between classes and extra projects, how many hours per week? So that's a good question. I mean, there's no real, this is the amount, but what I've told students is a general good number is maybe 3 to 5 extra hours a week on stuff for the BCSP. So if you've got a student, for example, taking, you know, English and math, I would expect that they'd be putting in 3 to 5 hours on their BCSP as well, whenever possible. And that's of course, that can fluctuate, because, you know, obviously there'll be times when they're more busy than others, but that's my general number when kids ask me that question. So if they're doing an online course, that would equate to maybe 45 minutes a night, half an hour a night, something like that. Does my program integrate into pre-AP and AP courses? I'm not sure exactly I need some clarification on it, but I believe so. Like the AP course. So when I teach the ICS4U course, it is the AP curriculum that we're doing. So I am actually preparing students exactly for the AP course. It actually just happens that the curriculum for the ICS4U is pretty much the same thing that kids need to know when they're doing, if they want to do the AP course or AP exam. So basically when kids go into grade 12, they can decide to sign up for the ICS4U kind of normal version, or they can sign up for the AP version. And if they sign up for the AP version, they basically do a little bit extra and do a few little extra sessions with me getting ready for the AP stuff. So this is our beautiful facility at Bay Ridge. This is the computer room, or outside the computer room, with all the motivational posters and our TV that scrolls through a slideshow of all the things going on at Bay Ridge. I'm trying to hold so that will change slides. Prove that, there we go, see, different things. And I put lots of student work up there as well, so very cool stuff. And here's our beautiful space. So we walk in, we have our back office, where students can often go back and use those green boards there to green screen things for videos. And then here is our computer room. So very spacious, we got lots of windows. We've got the blinds closed right now because of the sunny day and we were showing a video, but lots of computers around the outside, big whiteboard, projector up there. Let's just see the whole thing. And then at the back, we have our big giant green screen where we film Blazer News and do lots of assembly videos and stuff like that. And there's your 360. So yeah, big space and lots of room to work. So beautiful facility. Would I be interested in touring? Yes, I would love to get out to a robotics lab. Certainly when things calm down in the COVID realm, absolutely, I would love to. This is very similar, actually. It's amazing how, if you live in Kingston long enough and talk to enough people, the way I found out about Ingenuity Labs down at Queens was my daughter happened to play hockey with someone who, their dad was the guy who runs that lab. And then I taught a student whose father happened to be an administrator at the Center for Advanced Computing. So yeah, we've developed a lot of links in the community just through word of mouth. And I love to get more and more. The more opportunities I can offer to kids in terms of whether it's robotics or programming or cybersecurity, I'm interested in all facets. That's kind of what I want to do, actually. That's the idea behind the program. It was just kind of me looking at what we offer in the classroom and thinking, you know, that's just one little part of computer science and we're missing out on all this other stuff. And so that's really what I want to do with this program, is immerse the students in all kinds of different stuff and let them pick what they really, really like. That's the point, giving them the freedom and the creativity. So, yeah, I really appreciate everybody taking the time. It's 8 o'clock now. That's a good hour. I'm more than happy to stick around if you have any other questions and want to do like a one-on-one chat. But if that's it, then I guess everybody can take off. You can email me anytime you like. If there's ever any other questions that we can answer for you, we're happy to do so. I'm not great at saying this, but I really do believe that we have the best computer science program and the best math program in the entire board. And I mean that. I'm a little biased, but I really mean it. So if you want any other information, please don't hesitate to reach out anytime. But other than that, thank you so much, everybody, for coming. And stay safe. Have a wonderful holiday, and we'll talk to you all very soon. Thanks so much.